You're watching the 2019 SCAC Fall Media Days. It's day 8, and we're taking a dive into the Colorado College men's soccer program. The Tigers coming off a 13-6-1 campaign a season ago, 11-4-1 in SCAC play, second place in the regular season, and a trip to the SCAC semifinals. The Tigers will once again be led by head coach Scott Palguta, along with senior goalkeeper Keller Mochel. Coach Keller, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks for having us.
Coach, we'll start with you. You enter your fifth season as the head coach there in Colorado Springs. How excited are you for the start of a new year? What's your mindset going into preseason, and what do you enjoy most about this time of the year?
Preseason's one of the most fun times of the year, for sure. It's a fun experience for the guys, obviously. They almost get a taste of what it's like to be a professional soccer player. No classes just yet, so they get to, you know, eat, sleep, take care of themselves, take care of their bodies, train hard. And just eat, sleep, and breathe soccer every day, which is a lot of fun, and we obviously get to be a part of that with them. So, you know, the first week of preseason is always an exciting time, not just for the players, but for the staff as well. And obviously we have to dive right in, though. And so, you know, we try to get as much accomplished as we possibly can during a very short period of time and kind of walk that tightrope and find the balance between getting questions answered that we need going into the season and training hard, but also not overdoing it and making sure we're ready to go to play back-to-back games against really good teams opening weekend.
Keller, for you in your senior season last year, you know, you take a big step forward. You jump into that starting role as a junior in net. What's different for you now coming into camp this year as a senior? And is there a sense of urgency for you on your end being at your last preseason?
Yeah, I mean, this season is just you know, getting used to having, you know, different guys maybe in the back, and also coming into this season already having a couple seasons under my belt, definitely stepping into more of a leadership role with more experience for sure. So a little bit more confidence there, willing to speak up a little bit more. Yeah, just overall a lot of excitement, also just soaking in every last minute I have with these guys.
Coach, as I look at your schedule, it's a pretty challenging one with some litmus tests pretty early in the year. You open with a couple of home games and then on the road in Ohio against a couple of national powers in Ohio Wesleyan and Kenyon. You know, how much do you look forward to that challenge with this team, you know, early on in the season? And do you think that difficult non-conference schedule will help this group down the season once you get into conference play?
That's the objective, right? I mean, everything we do is to prepare the group to win a conference championship in November. And in order to do that, whether you have to win back-to-back games or possibly three games in a row in the conference tournament, you know, playing high-level competition battle tests you and prepares you for that stretch run. And so we're really, really excited. I love playing top teams, right? That's what it's all about. I mean, you want to test yourself against the best, and it's come together that we have, you know, as of right now, three top 10 teams on our schedule. And obviously it's right off the bat, so we're really looking forward to it. It's going to be a really good measuring stick, like you said, an early litmus test to see what this group is made of. And no matter how we come out of that, I think it's going to really harden us for the stretch run in November.
Keller, you returned to anchor a defense that allowed just 18 goals a season ago, a .90 goals against average. That was second best in the league. But you graduate three all-conference defenders from that back line. As one of the leaders of this group, how important is this preseason to kind of reorganize that back four, kind of set the tone and get the message so that that back line is as prepared as they possibly can going into the year?
Yeah, I mean, it ultimately just comes with communication, and I know we've had guys for the past couple of years just ready to step up. We obviously did graduate some big players, but we've had big players waiting for their shot, so I'm incredibly excited to see how everyone works out and works together.
Coach, this team offensively scored 38 goals last season, which was third best in the SCAC, but you had 6 1-goal victories, including 5 1-0 wins. How do you kind of try and create more chances in that offensive third heading into 2019?
Well, it's interesting. If you kind of go back to our recent history, we've been doing it by committee, and the guys have really bought into that, and I don't think that's going to change as we go into this year. We've had a group that's really bought into the idea that everybody needs to contribute goals. That means center backs on set pieces. Obviously, you know, your attacking players across the front three or front two are going to be asked a little bit more than others, but attacking midfielders can't just be playmakers. They need to get in the box and score goals, and that's going to be our mentality again going into this year. You know, the guys have really done well with that. But we have not had, I think, a guy score over 8 goals in 5 years. Right? We haven't had a double-digit goal score, I believe, since Brandon Ogilvy. That's going back a ways. Obviously, we'd love to have that, and maybe this will be the year that we will. But we bank on everybody giving contributions, and the depth of our squad should be one of our strengths. And I do believe that there are a lot of goals out there all over the field for us.
Keller, individually last season, 55 saves for you, a .786 save percentage, and a .78 goals against average. That goals against average, second best in the SCAC. Take me through this summer as you trained, prepared, got ready for your senior year. What have you worked on individually to make sure you're as well prepared as you possibly can going into 2019?
Yeah, I mean, this summer I was living with a couple of teammates in California, and so we had a lot of time to train together, run together, and just play soccer ultimately. And then being back here with guys and just facing more and more shots has been great. So, you know, it ultimately just comes with the head down attitude and ready to get running for sure.
Coach, a little bit of some changes going on with your facilities you head into this year. Just talk about the excitement around that new turf field, what that will bring to this program, and how, you know, does that create a little buzz around with the guys as they get prepared for a new season?
Absolutely. Both of our program, men and women, are super excited. You know, we're a little bit behind our initial timeline, so we might have to wait an extra week or so till we actually get out there. Still a few piles of dirt at the moment, but once it's complete, you know, it's going to be done right. It's going to be well worth it. You know, the college has invested significant funds into that to provide our student athletes with one of the best facilities around. And so we're excited. It's a more modern turf with an organic infill. It's going to be cooler. It's supposed to be a little bit safer for the student athletes. And for us to make a permanent home out on Stewart Field is what excites me the most. Our guys have done a lot of bouncing back and forth between our two fields, one being turf, our lacrosse field, and then our game soccer field has always been grass. So in order to keep that thing nice for our playing style of the women's team, it required us to train a lot on our lacrosse field. And so now to be able to kind of move out there and be able to train and play our games on the same surface and really make that a home for men's soccer, I'm most excited about that. And I know the guys are going to be thrilled once they get out there, and the little extra weight that we might have is going to be totally worth it.
Keller, finally, to wrap things up with you, as you've had discussions with your teammates and you've looked ahead to this season, what are some of the goals for this 2019 Tiger men's soccer program, and what will be key in order to accomplishing those?
Yeah, I mean, I think ultimately the goal is to go as far as we can with as many wins as we can. But, I mean, that starts with a strong mentality and building the base and practices and building up the intensity each practice. So that's all I can say, yeah.
And, Coach, I'll end the conversation with you with this. The expectations for you with this team heading into this season look like what? What are kind of – if what plays out this season will be successful, how?
You know, as you just mentioned, your goals in the previous question, it's pretty simple for us in college soccer. We want to win a conference championship, right? And that means doing whatever it takes to be at our best in November. So we're hoping the early season schedule, those tough games, obviously our conference continues to get better and better every year. The parity continues to grow, and that's throughout college soccer. You know, all these things will help us get ready to be competitive and hopefully a championship caliber team in November, and that's the immediate goal, and it doesn't really change much every year. And so our expectations of the group are real simple. We can't always control the outcome. We can play great and lose to a good team, but you know, putting our best foot forward, controlling those controllables, and just kind of trusting this process along the way that we're going to continue to get better and that we're going to be firing on all cylinders in November. And so it's our job as coaches to do our part, to manage the workload, do what we can to try to keep the guys healthy. We all know that was a big problem for us last year, the lack of depth that we had down the stretch of the season. But this year we could be, you know, legitimately 20 deep if we can keep guys on the field and competing. And so, yeah, the expectation, give your best every day, you know, and we'll see where we're at the end. But I think with the group that we have, if we can do that, and as Keller said, keep a strong mentality day after day, grind away, that we can be a very good team by the end of the year.
Colorado College men's soccer program. Again, the Tigers will be led once again heading into the season by head coach Scott Palguta, along with senior goalkeeper Keller Mochel. The Tigers will open up the 2019 campaign on August 30th when they take on Albion. Coach Keller, thanks so much for your time today, and best of luck as you head into the season.
Thanks very much, Russell.
Thank you, Russell.